there's a very long list of the causes of facial pain. There are benign entities such as tumors inside the head. So occasionally there can be tumors at the base of the skull that can produce disturbance of the trigeminal nerve. There can be multiple sclerosis that can manifest with trigeminal neuralgia. So most patients undergo an MRI at some stage just to make sure these lesions are not present. In terms of the different causes of facial pain, it's quite important that a patient sees a neurologist at some stage in their journey so they can tease out the other possible diagnoses. It's quite important that we treat patients with Gamma Knife with a diagnosis of typical trigeminal neuralgia or typical glossopharyngeal neuralgia. And the reason for that is if patients have atypical facial pain or they have cluster headache, which can manifest in a very similar fashion, or if they have neuropathic pain. So rather than the nasty shocks and then nothing, and then the shocks again, where they in neuropathic pain, that the pain never really goes away, and there can be burning and constant discomfort, that tends not to respond to Gamma Knife. Trigeminal neuralgia can occur in multiple sclerosis. There is a known link. Sometimes we can actually see on an MRI scan the changes within the brain that are occurring during the multiple sclerosis and the demyelination. So sometimes there can be a plaque in the brain stem. And that's part of the brain, if you imagine, between my fingers. So it's very deep in the brain. And that's where the facial sensation nerves enter the brain. You can quite often see a plaque or an abnormality actually within the brain substance. So unlike the other hypotheses I was speaking about with typical trigeminal neuralgia of unknown origin, where we think the problem is as the nerve is interfacing with the brain, in multiple sclerosis, often the abnormality is seen within the brain substance itself. This means that the results from multiple sclerosis treatment and trigeminal neuralgia can be a bit more unpredictable than in the idiopathic trigeminal neuralgia, which is important. Historically, the outcomes have been a little bit hit and miss, 50-50. However, more recently, the outcomes in literature are much more favorable in reducing the frequency and severity of the trigeminal neuralgia pain. Certainly, Gamma Knife is something that we tend to choose in preference to the invasive treatments for multiple sclerosis, as it targets the nerve in a closed head fashion. Patient doesn't need to undergo open head surgery. It's convenient for patients who may have other disabilities from their neuralgia, such as requiring wheelchairs, etc. The practicalities of Gamma Knife makes things more simple, certainly in terms of recovery compared to after an operation. And the data from multiple sclerosis over the last 5 to 10 years using Gamma Knife has become much more favorable to us using this. Number one, the ideal patient to be referred either through their general practitioner or through their neurologist is someone who's tried medications for trigeminal neuralgia and it's not been enough, or the medications are causing too many adverse effects. These are the sorts of patients we can help with the next level of treatment, which is the brain procedures, Gamma Knife being one of them. In terms of the practicalities, probably the easiest way is to refer to Queen Square Radiosurgery Centre, where I work, and we are the Trigeminal Neuralgia Gamma Knife Service for the south of England. So I think that would be the easiest port of call, but of course, to my NHS or my private secretary, depending on the route of treatment. People ask whether they'll be left with scars on the face or the head after surgery, but not after Gamma Knife radiosurgery. So it's a closed head procedure. We don't make any incisions. We don't open the skull. We don't need to go through the brain to get to our target. It's what we call incisionless surgery, one of the zero access treatments we have. What you will be left with for a couple of days are the divots on each side of the forehead where the frame has been, which is the important three-dimensional map for us to target the nerve, but they settle in the 3 to 4 days afterwards and fill out